Hey, what's up guys? Sometimes you try to access the hard drive or folder on your computer or laptop and you receive a pop-up error saying you don't currently have permission to access this folder and prompt you to continue to permanently get access, and when you click continue, you get another pop-up saying you have been denied permission to access this folder. As it says, this is permission or ownership related issue and need to be changed. So stay tuned. In this short video, I will show you how to fix you don't currently have permission to access this folder error and you have been denied permission to access this folder error for Windows 11, Windows 10, 8, 7, and I believe it should work for all the lower versions of Windows as well. My name is Mazhar and at Right Solutions I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's continue with this video. So the folder I'm trying to access is in my USB drive. So let's continue and see how we have the problem. So this is the PIX folder which I need to get access. As I double click on it, it just come up with this pop-up saying you don't currently have permission to access this folder. Click continue to permanently get access to this folder here. So if you click continue, so you get another pop-up saying you have been denied permission to access this folder. To gain access to this folder, you will need to use the security tab. So actually, if you click on this, it will take you to the security tab, but normally there is another way. Let's close this one and let's go right from the beginning. So here, where is the PIX folder? Whatever the folder you are trying to access, just right click on it and go down to properties, and from properties here, if you just look on the top third tab which says security, so just click on this. So this is the security tab which have these settings, or maybe you can access these settings from this tab here, and of course you need to click on advanced afterwards, but we will not do it from here. Let's go back again and just double click this folder again and click continue here, and then click on the security tab, so it brings up the same pop-up again. So now from here, just go click on advanced, and as soon this new pop-up will come here, you will see that there are some options here. It says the name of the folder, and then it shows the owner, and of course it's mentioning that unable to display a current owner. So what you need to do is to change the ownership. So just click on this change button here, and now you will get new pop-up here. So from this pop-up here, you can just see that you can select the users or maybe the groups, or you can just if you look at this blank space where the cursor is blinking, you can just simply enter the username. And how to find the username, just click on the start button here and you will just see that you see this icon here, and just go on it, you will see a user who is actually logged in right now. So anyway, so after finding this, you can just go back again, but we will not type this here. You can simply type this name what you find here, but what we'll do is here, just click on the advanced tab again, and now from here you can just click on find button here, find now, and you will see all these groups and all these users. So let's extend these tabs a little bit so you can just read it. So you can see all these names. You can just click any of this. I mean, the best thing is if you want to give access to everybody, so you can just simply click on everyone, and then you can change the permission to everyone, whoever is computer user, or maybe using your computer, so he can just have this access. But we will not do that. Let's just go browse down, and I believe we will go back up here, and let's click on administrator. So click on the administrators and just click OK again. And then you can see that the desktop or my computer name and the administrators had been typed, or maybe appeared on the place where you could actually type your name. If you just type the name, so you can just click on check names. So just click on OK here. And now after clicking on OK, you can just come this bottom. There are sometimes, you know, this some more additional permissions possibly may required. So just click on all these three tabs and see if there's any other option for you to just click or change any permissions. So most probably effective access sometimes have some additional permissions, but if there's nothing, then you can just simply go and click on apply. It will just give you a message that you don't have permission to read the controls of directory, of the name of the directory, and so on and so. And all permissions will be replaced if you press yes. So we just want to replace the permission, so just click on yes, and now it will also show you another security warning that if you have just taken ownership of this object, you will need to close and reopen this object. It's just a kind of a notice, so just click on OK again, and OK, click OK again, and then from click OK again and click close here. And now if you double click on this folder, it is giving you again that you currently you don't currently have permission to access this folder. Click continue to permanently again to get access to this folder. We had actually changed the permission, so just click continue, and voila. Here we see that all the content of this folder are appearing on your Explorer. So if you click on them, you can just open whatever the files are. So in my case, these are images, PNGs. If you think this video was helpful, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. I will see you with some other videos soon, and you have a great day.